start?
I'm recording.
Okay. We're outside of the Walmart. I'm here to do some shopping. I have my Go Green reusable bag so that I can look for products that are actually helping the environment. We'll see what I find. So one of the first products that I researched was Airwick, because they have partnered with the national parks and claim to be supporting the preservation of the national parks. So they've created a line of fragrances made of chemicals to support national park preservation. So we have the Grand Canyon fragrance, American Samoa, Denali, a lot of American monuments that we preserve in the national parks. So we'll see if they're actually doing anything to support the national parks. Searching for the right type of dish soap can be really overwhelming, especially if you're trying to find a product that doesn't hurt the environment, especially when so many of those products claim that they're not hurting the environment, but they actually are. So we're about to find one of our biggest offenders, and I'll let you guess which one is the offender. Greenworks is actually a huge offender on the list of greenwashing. I've done research about their products, and while they claim that they are 97% naturally derived, they're not actually sticking to their word. And I'll explain that more later in the research that I've done. But Clorox Greenworks is a brand that doesn't just exist in dish soap, it exists in a bunch of different cleaning products that I'll show you later. But Seventh Generation is actually one that might seem to be committing greenwashing, but isn't. This is a safe product to buy. They pass the greenwashing index test. They're not committing the six sins of greenwashing. So while I personally don't have a need to buy baby diapers in surplus or at all, I can imagine that for a parent that's concerned about the environment, that this might be a thing that they have to confront at some point. You know, you want a diaper that's not going to hurt your baby and also not going to hurt the environment, because those diapers end up in landfills. So what product might you land on? Okay, this is a green packaging. Huggies Pure and Natural. That seems like a good bet. Okay, so in trying to make a smart parenting choice for the babies I don't have, I picked up Huggies Pure and Natural because it says it has soft organic cotton, it's hypoallergenic, and it has aloe and vitamin E. So things from the earth that will protect your baby's bottom as well as protect the environment. But in the end, you're still putting tons and tons and tons of these into a landfill, right? It doesn't matter what it claims to do. Does Huggies actually do this? So what's the alternative? We're in the clothing aisle, and we're looking at cloth diapers, good old-fashioned Gerber baby cloth diapers, because these actually will reduce environmental waste and protect the environment, because there's no chemicals getting dispersed through the decomposing of the cotton fabric that they use to make those diapers.
What you want.
skipping over some of the big brands that we're familiar with, like Crest and Colgate. And we're stopped here at Tom's because it's natural. It seems like it's a small company. It seems like it could be good for the environment. We've got some pictures of leaves, pictures of mountains on the mouthwash. So we're hoping that this could be an eco-friendly choice. Unfortunately, Tom's is owned by Colgate. So what does it mean for a company like this to be owned by a big corporation? We'll find out. What makes a product good? At Tom's, it includes how we make it. No animal testing or animal ingredients. We share every ingredient, its purpose, and its source at www.tomsofmaine.com. Sustainable practices are a priority in every aspect of our business. No artificial colors, flavors, fragrance, or preservatives. We strive to maximize recycled content and recyclability of our packaging. And 5%, 12 days of employee time to volunteering, 10% of profits to human and environmental goodness. So, no trip to Walmart would be complete without stopping in the feminine hygiene products aisle. And if you're concerned about the amount of waste generated by this sort of a product, we're attempting to find something that might be a little bit better for the environment. So we've landed on Kotex Natural Balance. It says it has a touch of natural cotton, and they have this lovely symbol here. A lot of very simplistic marketing, really different from their Kotex U brand, which has high gloss packaging, uses a lot of ink. So this would appear to be the green alternative. However, it still uses plastic, the same amount of plastic that this brand uses, created by the same corporation. So if you're trying to avoid plastic, this is a product that you might land on. And while OB cotton still uses bleach and things that will hurt the environment as they decompose, it's a better alternative than something like this, which involves a lot of plastic that's going to take never to biodegrade. However, if you keep looking, you'll see something like this, which is fascinating to find in a big box store, and I'll talk a little bit more about that later. So we're shopping for a razor, and we've landed upon Chic Intuition Naturals, which has a lot of really lovely green sentiments in the packaging. It says earth-friendly packaging, it's 100% natural, it says recycle the box, and that it's made with 55% post-consumer recycling, post-consumer product. The only thing that is natural or organic about this product is the box, not what's inside of it. So while looking for a weed killer is kind of an eco-contradiction in and of itself, if you are buying a weed and grass killer, what product might you buy that would be the best for the environment? We found EcoSmart, which claims to be an organic weed and grass killer. It says it kills all types and it works fast, but it's an organic herbicide. The root word for killing plants, right? Which is kind of counterintuitive to what you might want to do to protect the environment. But if we look at their ingredients, the active ingredients, rosemary oil, okay, there's something that's natural and from the environment. It makes up 1% of the product. Other ingredients, 98.94%. Is it really that organic?